Alright, what is going on, my soldier gaming? It is our commander-in-chief, Warzone 157, and welcome to episode 22 of Warzone Talks, where the unnoticed get noticed. Now, before I get started, you're looking at gameplay of GTA 5 on survival mode. I get to about wave 5, and then for the lack of self-awareness, I get absolutely murked. And then on the other side of this video, you will be seeing me going on a nice little gameplay tear or streak with the shotgun in Star Wars Battlefront. I'm probably not going to be doing too many Battlefront gameplays unless it's very requested. Now, for all of those who are new to my channel, welcome. Hope you all enjoy your stay. Merry Christmas, and Merry Christmas to all of my other soldiers. And here's the rundown of this series. I go out and I find some awesome YouTubers out there, and either they have a low, medium, or high community behind them, or they just need a little bit of an extra boost. That's what I do. That's where I come in. Now, I'm a small content creator as well, but I do what I can by, you know, giving you guys positive feedback, subscribing to you guys, giving you tips on how to improve things on your channel, and pretty much sometimes I do little giveaways. Now, I know what you're thinking. After seeing my title for this episode, but I'm going to get to that. I'm going to get to that after my whole entire shout-out portion of this video. So, let's get started. First off, we have Halo Unity. They have 57 subscribers, and they were funded and founded by my main man, Spartan Fam, Spartan999. And he's got a good team base backing him up, and pretty much it is a channel created by Halo fans for Halo fans. And they want to be on the same aspect to Halo canon and Halo follower, but they're doing their own little thing to it. They want to have people come to their channel and want to try and work and collaborate with each other on making machinimas, talking about lore of the whole entire Halo community or Halo universe, doing a lot of commentaries, tips and tricks, and tons more. They even have some guy talking about making a PC game of a Halo game called Installation 01, which I do believe that could be a very good Kickstarter for me. Next up, we have Garbage Exposer. They have 298 subs, and they're pretty much gamers as well, but they're more of reviewers and ranters. More on the ranter side than review side. But I swear, the amount of energy they come in with each video that they made, because just like Halo Unity, they are still starting off with their channel, but they have great quality, great commentary, and pretty much are good to kind of articulate what they think about in a game, and they just pretty much say what makes it garbage. Now, some of it is a little bit not what I truly believe is bad, but I don't really try to, you know, argue too much about it, because they probably are 100% backing up their statement, and you can't have them disagree, because it's pretty much not going to happen. But if anything, I respect and honor their opinion. And from what I can tell with their commentary and how they talk to each other and try, you know, indulge themselves or have the viewer immersed in their channel or in their video, the way they talk and communicate, it's sort of like a podcast or newscast type of thing, news radio type. Because then you have that one person who's very calm, relaxed, and is articulate. And then you have the one guy going on an absolute tear, sounding absolutely outrageous, and having that one little spiel, that one little thing that have the person even more entertained viewing them, which is Rooney, Craig and Rooney. But the guy, his name is, I think his name is Rum. And I swear, he cracks some of the wisest jokes. And it's, especially on Star Wars Battlefront, while they say how much it's garbage, because everything they said, I 100% agree with. It's fun, it's cool, but it's not that great. It's more quantity over quality. And they also talk about that as well. And I just think that it has a potential to be not just a rant channel. It could possibly be something a whole lot more. Same with Halo Unity. So you guys are having a good standing on everything that you've been doing so far, and just keep up the great work. Next up, we have Asymptotic Gaming. He has 335 subscribers. He's a PC gamer and a commentator. He plays a lot of GTA 5, and sometimes he plays Borderlands the prequel or the pre-sequel. I forget what it's called. But he has a lot of games on there as well. He does a lot of games where he's playing co-op. And if he's doing collaborations, then it would be cool if he had his friend's channel in the link below. Sorry. And just, you know, helping his friends out. But if they're just, you know, people on the PS4 or PC or Xbox or whatever he uses, if it's just PC or if it's PC and other consoles, then, you know, he's just having a good time playing with friends, and their friends are in his video, and they're like, oh, it's so awesome. But the guy's commentary is great. I love his accent. He's very articulate. And he's also coming to me about wanting to try to do a face cam, but he was afraid because of how the internet is. Dude, what I said to most of my other subscribers, do it. Just do it. Don't be afraid because of what people think. You have choices to report them or spam them, to have them blocked from your comment section. Or if you just want to try and also be a bigger person of the matter, do what I do. Someone piss you off, say, you know what, man, thanks for the view. And I just love the people who come on my channel and dislike it because they don't pretty much like me because I'm not their preferred person. And that's what I feel is hilarious. I mean, honestly, it's your opinion, and I agree with it. But if you say that you don't like what I do, I'm sorry. That's my channel. That's what I do. It works for me for the most part, and I'm going to stick with it. But I thank you for the view. So either way, whatever you want to do, just do it. If you want to do a face cam, just stay on topic or go from topic to topic. Or just don't say anything at all, because Offshot Gaming does that exact thing. He has a face cam. He does some facial expressions. But he doesn't speak, and if he speaks, it's not that much. Me, I personally, I have to talk. I have to move around. I'm just that sporadic. And I think it's something cool, because it's something I haven't seen before. And he's playing Alien Isolation, he doesn't get scared, so I can tell that he's instantly already, in my books, a badass. And having that video and just looking at it, he's even more of a badass, because I scream a lot in Alien Isolation. But if you want to do face cams, man, go absolutely bonkers. You're going to have so much fun. And just think about it. That can actually help you progress. If you do something that's scary, you kind of get that endorse. You kind of get that rush afterwards. And then you kind of want to do it again. That's how I started doing face cams as well. It's just trial, error, and tribulations. You just got to do it and stick with it. If it's something that you really want to keep doing, and by all means, keep doing it. If you want any tips or tricks or anything, let me know. Alright, and next up we have Blasphemous HD TV. He has 555,223 subscribers. And what can I say about this guy? He is beyond hilarious. When it's coming to different channels that he has, one for pranks, one for video games and compilations, and the third one for him reacting. It is freaking phenomenal how he can even manage or micromanage each and every channel that he has. It takes a lot of skill, it takes a lot of work, and he's commended to it with his subscribers, as you can see by the number of people he has following him. I love how he, in some parts of him, is very Ebonic-like, and then on the other half of him is very proper and articulate, and he can match that up so well. And he may not be too funny sometimes, but when it counts, he will have you drop dead laughing. He even has story time where trials and tribulations of his life, or some kind of funny moment or exciting moment or happy moment in his life came to him, and he's reminiscing and giving you guys his thoughts on what happened, or just telling you what happened and how he still feels about it. And just the thought about him playing games with his girlfriend, and she's also in the midst of looking at the videos with him, or experiencing some of the scary games that he plays, and putting her inside the clips, especially with her, with his brother, or cousin, whichever one he is, and also with his best friend as well. That's cool, bringing in different people into your entire hobby or your career, if that's what you're making it into. So congratulations, Blasphemous, on getting all these subscribers, and I know you're going to get a ton more, Twizzlers. And last but not least, we have the celebrity of the video, and I think of everybody here as celebrities, but it's just that he has a little bit more going for him. He has a lot of more subscribers, or he's got a lot more creativity because he's been doing it, or she's been doing it for a long time. So the main celebrity I give a shout out to is Angry Joe Show. He has 2,333,744 subscribers. And this, he is very intelligent. He actually does his homework on the internet and actually doing podcasts with his friends describing on how some of the practices of some games are, either being DLC wise or season pass wise or anything that they can probably see as a problem. And they're nailing it on the head. While some people say that this isn't going to be happening, but when it does happen, he's the first one to actually say, you know what, I told you so. And he has the right to do so. He critiques the game very harshly, being Battlefront, Halo 5, didn't do one on Call of Duty, but the games that he absolutely dreads and just really gave a bad review on, it doesn't mean that he actually hates the game. He wanted to be into the game more than what he already was, but lack of either content or practices that these companies are doing nowadays, it's what sets his bar for these type of AAA games very, very low. And I can't get mad at him because I feel the same way. We shouldn't be ripped off. We should actually be the reason why these people are still making games. And right now it's like they're owning us, but we should be owning them. He does a lot of podcasts with his friends and talking about these things. He also does great reviews where he's paying attention to every single detail, game-wise, visuals-wise, story-based wise, acting-wise. And it's these things don't take 18 to 20 minutes to actually sum up. And if it is, then you're very fast in talking. Or you can just sum everything up in just a few words. He takes his time. He even entertains us with special effects and everything. He's got a big, huge, gigantic army on a PC. And if you want to be a part of it, I'm pretty sure that you still can. I mean, it's never too late to be a part of this guy's army, either on YouTube or being a PC gamer. He is very, very intelligent. He knows what he's looking for in video games. He is great when it comes to reviews, interviews. Love how he has reaction videos to certain trailers. And I do understand, and I agree with him, for the new Batman vs. Superman movie, that it should not be, and it should not be, Doomsday to be the main enemy. That should have been in the second movie that they will be making of this. But I guess not. And I think it is. But that's the end of the shoutouts for right now. If you want a shoutout, like I said before, let me know in the comment section below of this video or any further videos that I make in the future. And definitely check out these subscribers as well. They are very awesome. They're very cool, creative, and funny as all hell. And you might be surprised what they might bring to the table that you probably haven't seen before. So now let's talk about my title. Am I done with my gaming channel? Well, most of the time throughout this month, I was thinking about, you know, just stopping. You know, stopping completely. Because, let's face it, I'm, like I said before, I get into depression real fast, and I just feel like, am I really doing something with my time on YouTube? Have I really helped anybody out? You know, I was getting really, really down. Especially playing these AAA games who have just become very lackluster, very boring. And it's just like, where's the spark in AAA games now that I usually have fun with back in the day? Because it's not there. It's not there. Too many bad practices, and not a lot of consumers are speaking up about it. Which is really sad. It's really sad how you will have to work for these people when they should be working for us. And I'm going to keep on saying that. We should be the reason why they are going to their studio every day trying to make sure that their games are top notch. We're the critics. They are the creators. And it's our job to critique and want more from these creators. Battlefront, beautiful, but boring. It gets boring fast. I'm sorry. That's just my two cents on that. Halo 5, beautiful. It's fun. But people who like story mode, not gonna find it there. Black Ops 3, same fucking engine. Stupid ass campaign. Ridiculously stupid settings that they have for the new difficulty, which is realistic. And it's more choppy than Black Ops 2, which I'm glad for backwards compatibility, because I'll be playing that way more than I'll be playing Black Ops 3, unless they have a DLC for Bring Back the Noob Tube, and then I'll just try and work on getting my knife at rank 40. Thanks, Treyarch. But I don't want to stop making gaming videos. However, I'm going to try and start it to expand on different games. That being going to like indie games, ID at Xbox. Because these aren't AAA games. They're not being hyped up. I mean, Cuphead is being hyped up, but I guess I can see the hype, but at the same time, I'm not going to get too excited. Because you give these people too much air in their heads, they're gonna you give a person too much air, it's gonna go to their head, and everything that you wanted previously will be out the window. But I also want to give other games, other puzzle games, platform games a chance, because I don't really play too many of them. I always play action adventure shooter, first person shooter. I want to see what else is new. And right now I got a couple of selections. Not only do I want to play indie games, I also want to do bigger things with my channel. I want to do collaborations with other YouTubers or people on my friends list on Xbox and for PlayStation, because I will be getting a PlayStation in January or February. And I also want to do interviews with certain YouTubers, either as being big people like Angry Joe or smaller YouTubers like eCraziness Games or Lukey Doo, Spartan999, Effective Gamer, Ominous Shark, Asymptotic Gaming, Garbage Disposer, Halo Unity. Choices are endless. I want to know the people behind the game, the people behind the screen. And it just helps you know who these people are. It helps you build better relationships. It gives you more ways on building your own channel or your own legacy on YouTube instead of just being a person who plays games for a living. And that's pretty much what's showing for Angry Joe, because look at him. And others. So my gaming channel is not dead, however, it is evolving. For better or worse, it's got to change. I will make that change. And I just hope that you all are still going to be with me in that future endeavor. And I hope you all are going to be along for the ride. So before I end this video, I want to know, because it's time to actually try and give out gift cards for a PlayStation, Xbox, and PC. What is your biggest thing to do on YouTube? What are your thoughts on what you're trying to do new for YouTube, or try to do something new for yourself and have other people view your channel a little bit more, well, what's your New Year's resolution? What was the best thing that you got for Christmas? Let me know, and if I can find some of the best people out there who have some of the best, you know, responses, then guess what? You might be chosen. I'm getting either around $15 to $25 for a gift card. So that's that one little item that you want to buy. Guess what? Free money. That's pretty much going to be the end of this video. Definitely, like I said again, check out these channels. You will not be disappointed. And thank you all for watching. If you like what you see, be my personal firing squad and execute that like button. If you have a YouTube channel, let me know in the comment section below on this video or any other video. This is the best video that you've seen thus far. Please add to your favorites and let people know what I do for this channel on any social network that you use. And if you want to become part of my army today because I want you to be entertained and have your voice heard, then let me know in the then subscribe to stay updated. As always, this is Warzone 157, reminding you to keep your eyes on the prize and finger on the trigger at all times. This is going to be the end of my transmission. I will see you soldiers in the next battle log. So have a good day, night, wherever you're from. And as always, Warzone out, and Merry Christmas. Fingers crossed. Yes. Oh, so I need two more. God dang it. Alright. I was about to say alright, but then I was about to say okay, and it came out as, oh, you just heard it.
Did that? Oh my God!